Our stories used to be so simple. We had a beginning, a middle, and an end. But ever since we moved to this awful city, everything's gotten so confused.
Look, I didn't kill anyone.
And I'm supposed to just believe you. Snow. I just want you to be careful. I almost lost you once, and...
I'm not yours to lose. I'm not going to be an errand girl for Crane anymore.
She looks like Holly.
It's not Holly. It's her sister, Lily.
She was hooking to pay down debt. Eventually, the only people she owed were at her work. You know, that shithole club, the Puddin' and Pie.
My name is Narissa.
Well, Narissa, I've got some questions. The open arms.
Oh my God! What is it?
It's Crane. That motherfucking piece of shit!
Crane? Ugh, God, you think you'd know a person. Bigby, you have to tell her.
I know!
What's going on? What did you find up there? You know, other than the...
I just need to find Snow.
Why? What's going on?
Shit!
Crane's been... Whoa, Bigby, calm down. Everything's going to be fine. Okay, it's going to be fine.
Will someone please explain this to me?
Crane might be following Snow. If I can find her, I can... God damn it!
Okay, it's going to be okay. Where did you see her last? Did she say where she was going?
She took Holly to the business office to prepare for the funeral.
Lily's funeral?
Yeah.
How do you know?
I was just at the Trip Trap, and I heard Gren telling some folks about a funeral at the Buckingham Bridge.
The Trip Trap? Are you drinking?
When?
Right now. They were on their way out.
Bigby! Wait.
What?
Snow's been through a lot. There are things she doesn't talk about. Just please be careful when you tell her. And you should tell her. But...
I know.
No, you don't know. You know how you felt when you saw that picture? Well, it's going to be much worse for her. Just remember that.
Hey everybody, it is I, MisterSkids, and I just bumped my microphone turning this screen on, doing the screen wipe. So I'm here now to show you the next episode of The Wolf Among Us. And if you haven't already known, there is already quite a bit of a shitstorm going on between Crane, Bigby, and Snow White. And if you haven't watched the last episode to see what happened, please go back and watch that before watching this. But if not, let's get ready to enjoy some interestingness.
I'm honored to be asked to speak to
you. I hear Snow. I hear Snow. I hear Snow. I hear Snow. It's just it's raining, but I hear Snow. Pour the toilet.
People she trusted, cared for. I won't, offend you by claiming one day that the pain of losing Lily will ever subside.
I don't interrupt her. Not right now. Don't interrupt her. It's not
well
a good idea.
It will never subside. But I also
think...
know that the memory of Lily will sustain as well.
Hold on. Pause for the cause, because did the subtitles turn themselves off? No, the subtitles are on. Well, okay then. Let me... I guess I'm going to have to check out, see if that'll get it to work, turning it off and on. I don't understand what's going on there, but okay, whatever.
And it will,
nope,
in time, equal,
okay,
in strength to our mourning
for
loss.
I can't hear her now.
And it is in that spirit that I'd like to
talk about
what you've all been so grateful to share with me. Your
Sorry.
Memories of her. How she could be stubborn and patient, rash
Billy Goat
want.
Billy Goat.
How she carried a
whiskey.
Torch for the old ways, for tradition.
I'll miss worrying about you.
Pageantry.
I'll miss our fights.
And most of all,
I'll miss you.
It seems how
Holly.
Lily loved her friends and family. She
now
loved
you will never
around.
Die from indifference
good times
or lead
and
a tedious life.
I never met Lily.
Goodbye, sweetheart.
What I've
Thanks
been
for
told.
Everything.
I know
Vivian.
In my heart that she would have liked to be here tonight. And now we'll have our moment of
you
silence.
You're a big, bright,
Thank
shining
you.
Star in this shithole of a town. And I miss you already.
Oh, Gren. I'm so sorry, guys. I'm so sorry.
Is everything okay?
No, not you.
Holly, it's...
He wasn't fucking invited.
Holly, wait.
He has no right to be here.
I'm sorry,
not
I don't want...
what he did.
Holly, I'm sorry.
Holly, I'm sorry, but I had to come.
You throw my sister down the witching well, and you have the nerve to show your face.
What?
Here. After you lie, after you promise me.
I didn't throw
Holly,
her down the witching well.
That was Crane, just Crane. He disposed of Lily's body before Bigby could do anything about it.
Yeah, I had no...
I'm telling you the truth.
Don't
yeah.
cover for him.
But this genuinely wasn't his fault.
You can't tell me Bigby gives a shit about this.
I do.
Holly,
I do care.
Be okay.
I'm sorry, Holly. I didn't know he put her down the witching well.
Bigby cares, Holly.
I do
He's
care.
He's trying to help. And
I really
I'm sure
do.
He has a very good reason for being here.
I do.
This one isn't on him.
Why are you here anyway? And don't say it's because you care about this.
Everything okay?
Ah!
I'm here to talk to Snow.
Oh, really?
Yes,
yeah.
Holly. This is serious.
Sorry, Holly.
Okay.
But this...
okay, look. Bigby and I are going to have a little chat far away from the ceremony, all right?
Yes. Don't worry. I will have it very
look,
far
Holly,
away.
I know how this must...
No, you don't know how this must feel. You have no idea. Don't fuck anything up. Don't bother anybody.
I'm
and
sorry,
when the
I got...
first sign of trouble comes, and it will come because you're a goddamn walking trap for it, I want you the fuck out of here. You hear me?
I just want Lily's killer.
I just want to get Lily's killer, Holly.
Okay.
Let's discontinue, okay?
This is such total fucking bullshit.
I know
Let's
it's bullshit.
Go, Holly. It's your turn to talk.
I'm sorry, everybody. Why? Why does everybody blame me? Except for they're not really blaming me. They're actually blaming the Big Bad Wolf. But, I mean, come on. Come on. I didn't do anything wrong.
This better be wildly important. It's been hard enough making a connection with these people. When you pull this kind of stuff, it just resets the clock.
Crane murdered Lily.
What?
I followed a lead to this shithole motel, the Open Arms. Crane had a room there, and he's been taking prostitutes, or at the very least Lily, and making her look like you while he was, you know. The bed was covered in blood. I know it was him.
This is... I don't even know what to say right now. I really don't.
I'm sorry.
I'm just trying everything I can right now to not picture it, to not picture him.
I'm sorry, Snow. And I'm sorry I had to be the one to tell you.
You're sure this is what happened? This is what he's been doing?
I don't know if he murdered him.
Don't confuse things. Deposing Crane would be the next step. And if we get this wrong, it would mean more than our jobs.
Crane has been taking photos, Snow. Lots of photos.
Photos that show him...
He's been recording his visits with Lily.
God.
I didn't want to show her.
Let's go back to the business office. I doubt Crane's there at this hour, but we need to talk. And this isn't the place. Snow? Narissa? What is it?
I'm sorry, but Holly's asking for you.
Are they starting the burn?
Yes. Everyone who spoke should really be present for this part.
Okay.
She's kind of distraught. You're not leaving yet, are you?
Let her finish. You can finish.
I don't mean to be,
No, I understand.
It's just that something's come up.
No, I get it. Take your time.
It won't take long.
I tried to be a nice guy as much as I possibly go.
At the motel. Did you find anything?
I did.
No?
I did. It helped a lot. Thanks.
I don't really want to tell her.
Coming.
I'm sorry. I don't really think you should know right now. Now is not the time. You should know a little later. Things are a little bad right now.
Constable.
Oh.
Wait, easy now, girl. You know how this goes. The first thing in a visit, you say, "How do you do? How do you do?"
Now.
Anyway, it's proper.
It's now is not.
Now is really not the time for whatever you Jergovs are planning to do.
Well, isn't that the thing of it? Plans. Except it isn't our plans you should be concerning yourself with. We'll snip to the chase for all sakes. A little bird told us that you're fitting to go after Crane. And you see, we have an interest in that particular boy. So you leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone. Just take a little vacation is all. Don't even have to go anywhere. Just sit in your office and whistle to heaven for a few short days.
Are you working for Crane? Did he send you?
No. See now, you're already asking too many questions. Just pay attention. So
oh,
what's
boy.
It gonna be? We have a deal? You leave Crane alone and we leave you to yours?
Just don't hurt anyone.
Just don't hurt anyone, D.
That don't sound like a yes to me. Always wanting to do things the fun way.
Ladies, gentlemen, invertebrates, please, rest easy. This is not...
What the hell is going on?
What's happening?
Very sorry to impose, but we only had a deal to work out with Bigby. And we're unhappy to report that things did not go as smoothly as planned.
Oh, I'm gonna kill you guys.
Never you mind that. It ain't any of your...
What deal?
D, no deals.
Settle down now. Yeah, everyone just stay where you are, nice and natural.
Stop this shit, right now.
He hasn't exactly been a good sport about this.
And you're not
making our lives any easier.
You fucking D's.
What did I tell you? What did I say?
Holly.
I was leaving. I'm sorry.
You two motherfuckers could come here uninvited. You think you can just fucking interrupt Lily's funeral?
Calm down, darling. It was just a simple business transaction.
You fucking freaks are not getting away with this.
Holly, don't move.
Yeah, listen to your lady, love. Things don't have to turn sloppy now.
Yeah.
Calm down, Holly.
Everybody,
yeah,
calm down.
Spare all the fuss. It's just a dead hole.
No.
I'm gonna kill you.
No.
Holly.
I got it, damn.
No, grab it. Get him. Breed him the fuck up. Kill. Ah. Beat the fuck out of him. No. Oh. Goddamn D's! Goddamn Tweedles! That's it. They're dead. No more Mr. Nice Guy. God damn it. Goddamn you Tweedles! I went easy on you! I let you live! I stopped Bluebeard from fucking killing you. I stopped Bluebeard from taking you apart. I didn't fucking touch you because I thought maybe that just maybe you would remember how easy I went on you. and you turn around and you give me this, we're done, Deez. I'm going to kill you both. You're fucking dead. We're done. I just wanted people to be fine and safe. I didn't want people hurt. Now you're fucked. You are fucked, good sirs. God, what a way to introduce the first episode. The third episode, I mean.
God. God damn it.
Is that Svineheart?
I did as well as I could to take out the buckshot, but there's still some shards left embedded in your shoulder. They'll eventually worm their way out on their own, but until they do, you're gonna be sore.
Bigby, Dr. Svineheart was appointed Fabletown physician for a reason.
It's okay. There's only one thing you have to take away from all this. Take it easy.
I can't do that right now.
Don't go looking for any more fights. Keep strain off your heart. And try and get some rest.
How's everyone else? They all make it?
They're fine.
Good.
I had everyone that got wounded sent home. Holly refused to let me see where she lived. So I left her and Grendel back at her bar with a dose of juniper and spring water.
Good. I'm glad they're okay.
They'll be fine. Just remember what I said. The stitches won't hold up if you continue to act like you normally do.
I'm sorry.
In moderation. And eat more chicken.
I'll try to.
Eat more chicken, okay. You say. Okay.
Very good.
I'll give it my best.
Business office. I know. I'll have to call you back. The town is starting to find out.
Well, I'll leave you two to it then. Miss White? Bigby?
I tried. I really did.
So, to recap,
Crane watched me through the magic mirror uncover his room at the Open Arms, and then he smashed it so we couldn't use it ourselves to go after. And we know this because Bufkin was drinking in the rafters. That about cover it?
And once he puts all the pieces back together, it'll be easy to catch Crane.
So it can be fixed.
I guess that's the plan, currently. But I don't know.
Do we have any other leads?
No other leads. This is it. Just wait for the mirror.
Yeah. What the hell is going on? I don't know what the Tweedles get out of this. I don't know if Crane sent them. I don't know if... I mean, this is gonna sound crazy, but do you really think Crane did it?
I'm not sure.
Do you really think he killed those women?
I'm not sure.
It's incomprehensible to me.
I'm as confused as you are, to be honest. I don't know.
What did he have to gain to kill them?
Makes sense.
He was a conniver, a coward, a liar. And I'll always hate him for that. And I'll hate him for how he held me in his thoughts. But murdering prostitutes? Ow! Everything okay over there?
Yes, Miss White. Just cut myself on a piece of the glass. Nothing to worry about.
Thanks for tonight, by the way. That could have gone really terribly. I mean, even worse than it did.
Yeah.
I'm glad you were there.
I just feel bad for Holly, really.
Yeah, it was my... If I wasn't there, those Tweedles wouldn't have been there.
Eventually. At least, I hope so, for her sake.
I'm so sorry, Holly. You didn't deserve this.
Can I, ask you a question? It's kind of personal.
What?
And I don't want to offend you, but after tonight, it's on my mind.
What's on your mind?
What's on your mind?
It's just, when stuff hits the fan, like it did tonight, it feels like before we came to the city. It feels kind of like home. And I've heard it said that maybe in some tiny little bottled up way, deep inside, you kind of enjoy it when things go wrong. Because it gives you an excuse to just, stop pretending.
Fuck no, I don't enjoy it. Are you kidding me? It's horrible what happened tonight. I wish it didn't happen.
I shouldn't have said anything. Forget that I did.
Sorry, Snow.
Guys? We have a problem.
What is it?
I can't finish the mirror. It's missing a piece.
Oh, Crane stole it, too.
What do you mean, missing a piece?
Yes, it's not here.
Crane must have taken a shard with him.
Yep.
Oh, I can't believe this.
I saw Crane pick something up after he smashed it. I'm sorry, I didn't realize what it was until now.
Well, the mirror can't work unless it's whole.
Well, that's not entirely true.
Or what, Buffkin? What? We sit around and wait until it mends itself? We have no idea how long that will take. We're just gonna have to do this the hard way.
I'm just saying, waiting is an option.
No. We can't depend on the mirror.
All right. How long will it take for the mirror to reform?
Well, it could take days.
Or months, or years. He had to have left something that tells us where he's going. He's a neat freak, but he was never that smart.
Smart enough to take a piece of the mirror.
Buffkin, not now.
We can solve this ourselves. I know
that.
Never
mind that. Come help me look.
Yes, let's go look for clues. We don't have time for this. We don't have time for the mirror right now. We need to act before things become too shit. Is there any clues? Buffkin, what do you got to say, Buffkin?
Hi, Mr. Bigby. I can still help you catch Crane, you know.
Oh, you can?
Yes. I saw him jump on the telephone before he left. He called up somebody. He said he needed to see his witch, or that he would need to get to the witch for that, whoever that is.
His witch?
Yes, it sounded like the one he got his snow glamours from.
Did you see anything else?
Anything else, did you?
No, not especially.
It wasn't your fault.
The whole mirror thing? It's not your fault, right?
You mean it?
Yeah.
No. It's not your fault. I'm not gonna blame him for stopping him.
I'll just see if I can do anything about this.
You look how small he is compared to Crane. Crane might not be that strong looking, but, I mean, he's twice the size of fucking Buffkin. Of course Buffkin's not gonna try stopping him. That would be insane. He probably would get killed. So I understand if Buffkin didn't stop him for that reason. Ah, goddammit, I keep getting stuck on stuff. Let's see, is there anything over here? I can't inspect the book. Crane's desk. Nope, there's nothing. Making random noises because I don't like dead air. You can't have dead air, as
Buffkin
the radio show host knows.
Overheard Crane call somebody before he left. Sounds like he's going to see a witch, or his witch. His glamour witch.
Wait, really?
The one that makes the illegals.
None of the 13th floor witches would allow that sort of thing. They must be somewhere in the city.
Back alley, probably.
It's something, at least.
Find anything?
No, but there's enough notes and stuff here to take all night.
Oh,
maybe
God,
check that
it.
Stuff there.
What stuff? Alright, I'll take a look. Oh, what have we got here? Inbox. Let's look at the inbox. I saw a key.
What is it?
It's the key to his room at the Open Arms.
Well,
you still haven't told me what was in there.
I
want to know. I need to know.
Crane was paying Lily to live out a fantasy of him and you together.
God damn it!
Forgive
I didn't want to tell
you the details.
I keep thinking back. I keep replaying moments in my head. Interactions with him when he'd catch me in the elevator or bump into me outside. There's only so much you can repress, you know?
You couldn't have known.
You couldn't have known.
No, I could have.
No.
Come on, let's keep looking.
You couldn't have known. He hid it pretty well by the looks of it. They're up to Ichabod Crane, are there any updates on the extra funding I requested? As I explained in my last letter, the conditions here could do with some improvement. I'm seeing some unrest from the residents, and I have to admit I can see why. The farm should not be a punishment. I'm sure you're busy, but I think this should be made a priority. Waylon Smith. Crane! It's your fault the fucking farm is an awful place, too. I hate him so much. Dear Mr. Ichabod Crane, I am writing to ask again that you please send someone to fix the air conditioning in our unit. It's burning up the apartment and Pinocchio says his skin is splintering. I don't know what that means, but I assume it's something gross and I really like it if you'd fix the air like we asked you 3 months ago. At the very least, provide us a fan in the meantime. Sincerely, Boy Blue. He is fucking useless. What a fucking piece of shit. Just like almost lots of other politicians, but we seriously need to get rid of him. Mr. Crane, you said you'd pay to have the blaster redone in my building after the last incident in 204. It's falling off the fucking walls. Please fix it. I can't rent out that room as it is, and I've already been waiting for days. Not to mention you already promised me you'd send someone to fix the big crack in the glass in the front door. Well, guess what? It's worse now. Get your shit together, Mr. Toad.
Did Green ever do any work?
No, apparently fucking not. Apparently fucking not, you the worthless piece of shit. Ah! The more I find out about him, the worse it gets. The worse it gets. Yeah. Thought so. Yeah, that look. So let's take a look at what he was hiding. What we got? What we got?
There's a page here that was torn out.
Oh yeah? Bufkin, do you know what was here?
What do we got, Bufkin? The king of...
It's a ring, at least. Every magical item not retained in the armory is assigned to someone in Fable Town. It must be this witch he is going to see.
Yeah, I only recently heard about this meeting. Why didn't you mention this before?
Meeting?
No one asked me.
Bufkin!
And I'm hungover. I'm sorry. We set the meeting at 2 a.m. tonight.
What's going on? Is the mirror fixed yet?
Bluebeard, this isn't the time.
Get the fuck out of here, you murderer.
You called me to...
I called just to see if you knew where Crane could be, and that was it, okay? And I'm sorry I said anything more than that.
Well, you did, and I know. The cat's out of the bag. So, can we find the dull pervert or not?
I tried
this
to, but...
This isn't your concern.
Oh, it isn't?
No.
Damn it, I missed it.
Business.
Yes.
None of my business? Crane's the murderer. He escaped. It seems he spoiled your every attempt at locating him. And now it's none of my business?
We don't know if he's the murderer.
Oh, yeah. Please. Of course he is.
Look, this
says the murderer.
Isn't the time. He took a piece of the mirror, so we can't use it.
The only thing we know is that Crane's going to see a witch at 2 o'clock.
Yep. Wait a minute.
A.M. or P.M.?
A.M.
Listen, Bluebeard, you're not a part of this.
I don't think you're in any position to
tell. Bluebeard, why do you care?
Help.
Why do you even care about this?
Yeah.
I'm invested in this enterprise we call Fable Town.
This isn't an enterprise,
literally,
you fucking
invested.
Jack.
Since it's mostly my money that keeps the whole thing running. And tonight I hear that Crane has been killing fables, and there's no system in place to catch him?
Look, we know that Crane is going to see a witch, and it's to acquire a magic ring.
What's the ring?
We don't know what it does or who it's assigned to since Crane tore its page out of the book.
This farce was your ridiculous idea for a plan. I mean, who put you in charge in the first place?
Fixing the mirror was the most logical
thing. You're a secretary. He's the sheriff. And none of you were chosen to run this office. Who elected you to make these decisions?
Nobody, but that
who
doesn't...
Who elected her to spend my money?
Well, I've been doing that unofficially for years now.
Unofficially is not officially.
Snow can handle this.
Handle this, so let's drop it.
Well then, excuse me for having the Commonwealth in mind.
You don't have nothing in mind other than your own fucking pocket, asshole.
All right, let's just look on the bright side. We know Crane is going to see the witch that's been supplying him black market glamours.
Thanks to me.
And that he'll be there at 2. So that gives us a few short hours to find out who it is and where they live and get them all at once.
And a few shorter hours, the more you babble about it.
We haven't been the ones babbling.
Yeah, yeah. Just point in the direction you want me to check first.
Since Lily used the glamours, she'd have known who the witch was. And I don't think Holly's burned her things yet. It would probably have the address or a phone number or something.
And Bigby is free to go there if he likes. But I think the question you should be asking is just what do the two Tweedles know about this?
Everything, apparently.
It doesn't matter what they know. After tonight, they'd never go to their office.
They're not smart enough to try and go anywhere else.
The Trip Trap is the better option to track the witch down.
Lily stuff.
Has to be our focus.
Lily stuff. We gotta focus on Lily stuff.
That'd probably be the safer bet.
I don't really care what you two do. I'm going to his apartment.
What? You can't just go up there.
And why the hell not?
We already looked for the key, remember? I don't know where it is.
Then I'll pick the blasted lock! I've wasted enough time waiting for the mirror to find him. I won't waste any more.
You just can't go up there alone, all right?
I've no interest in nicking his drapes, my dear, if that's what concerns you.
What concerns me is you traipsing through possible evidence.
Oh, now it's evidence. Before you had no interest, and now it's a crime scene.
Fine, go ahead.
Care.
Just stay out of the way.
We can't just let Bluebeard run amok in Crane's place.
Ha!
He's after something. I just don't know what it is.
I guess...
We have to find the witch, Bluebeard, since that's where he's going.
Or the sniveling weasel chickened out. Never went anywhere. And is upstairs right now in his pitiful penthouse, crafting a fort out of couch cushions.
No.
Look, this is how a smart person would do it. So this is how we're going to do it. Wherever you go, I'll go to the other.
I don't like you going anywhere unsupervised.
Fuck.
He's up to something. I don't know what it is, but we don't have the time to really worry about it.
Oh no, Bluebeard, I don't need you. I do not need you in my way right now. We need to find the witch.
So you leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone.
I'd love to join you, but there's some business I need to attend to.
No, I'm better off dealing with things alone. I don't need sympathy and I don't need charity.
Fuck. This is not good. I'm not good to make this decision right now. No. Crane's apartment, Dee's office, Holly's bar. Crane might have taken all the evidence out of his room by now. Lily's stuff might have been compromised, too. Going to Dee's office might be a really bad decision. He might know information on the Crooked Man, but he also might know information on Crane right now. I don't know. I gotta keep Bluebeard out of the office. I gotta keep him out of someplace, out of Crane's apartment. Like Snow said, he's probably looking for something that's important to him that might fuck us over big time later. I don't like the D's that, I don't like Tweedledee's and Tweedledums running around able to get at me at any point with that shotgun. I'm thinking Crane's apartment. I think that might be our best
Crane's
chance.
Place is right here. I should check that out first.
Perfect. And I'll go to those two imbeciles' office.
Crane's penthouse number is 1903. Let me know what you find. I hope you know what you're doing.
I hope so too. I hope I know what I'm doing too. I'm sorry. No, I probably made a horrible decision. I'm so sorry. Oh, that was a tough choice. But here we go. Ready? Let's Let's go on into Crane's room and see just what we can find. What room was it? I can't remember now. The examine.
This is Briar Rose's place.
Who's Briar Rose?
Snow said Crane lives in 1903.
Oh, Trushbeard. Oh god, the door is fucking open already. Not good. Well, coming here was a big mistake.
Why's the door open?
That's not good.
Anyone in there?
Somebody's in here. Crane? Either somebody's... No, I fucked up. I fucked up. I shouldn't have came here. I think I screwed up. Crane.
Damn it. Must have missed him. There's gotta be something about his witch here.
He's gone. I bet you anything he took whatever evidence he had and left with it. Oh god, what the hell? Whoops, my bad. Was that his clock going off? I kinda interrupted it by accident.
I've seen him that excited. Guess things have changed.
Times change,
math,
man.
Science, history. If I had to guess, this shit didn't work.
Something tells me, yeah. No, it did not work. Cannot go on the balcony, anything in the wine cabinet. One of the wines is missing.
Found in the open arms.
That's what I thought. Unfortunately, that's what I thought. Why, Crane? Why are you disgusting? Oh, hey. Answering machine. What you got on for me? What you got for me? Anything good?
Crane. Look, the crooked man isn't happy, compadre, and as much as I like making house calls, I have better ways to use my time. So, if you can go ahead and pay him by Friday, that would be great. All right?
Man.
Everybody can stay upright. In the meantime, leave the light on, pal. See ya!
So Crane was under the crooked man's thumb.
This hasn't been used in years.
Merry Christmas, Mr. Crane. Thanks for all your help this year.
He used to teach in the old days.
Yes, he did. Yes, he used to be a big time. He used to be a teacher, college educated and everything. So he was definitely underneath his thumb.
My dearest Snow, I know you must be aware of my feelings towards you. Watching you work, if I am unable to control myself, it's because I love you.
Fuck off. Gross. Fuck you, Crane.
Crooked man.
I knew it.
This is all I could get. I'm afraid Snow will start to notice. I'll have the rest for you next week, Ichabod Crane.
That's why
what's
there's...
going on here?
Confiscate the money. Confiscate it. It's not going to do any good sitting here. Not that I'm going to spend it, but I'm going to confiscate it just for evidence reasons. No, don't think it that way. God damn it, I'm not fucking crooked. I'm just taking the money because it might be useful later on. We might need that as bargaining chip. That's the Headless Horseman. Why would you keep that around? Why would you keep that around? So definitely... So Ichabod did something with the crooked man. Either he took out a loan and he's now laundering money through Fable Town to pay off his debts to the crooked man. He has been selling us all down the goddamn river this entire fucking time. And that's why he hasn't been paying for things or anything like that. He hasn't been paying for things that the Fable Town needs. Is it all because he's been paying off whatever bullshit he caused? Goddamn scumbag. No wonder everybody's been on hard times. It's literally all Ichabod Crane's fault. he's sold himself out to the fucking crooked man for whatever reason. Okay, anything... Okay, here's the bust. Is there anything... Yeah.
Really?
Yep, really, apparently. Apparently, he thinks of himself that highly. So I got a key. I got a key that, Oh, bedroom door. Kick open. Use key on. Let's try the key. See if this actually works. Yep, that worked. Jack! Grab him now!
Jack.
You.
Wow, it is just unbelievable running into you here. I mean, of all the places. Weather, right? A little damp, I guess. But you know,
explain.
Some people like that sort of thing. You know.
Now.
Explain yourself. Now.
Okay. I know what it looks like, but before you go jump into conclusions, Crane pays me to water his plants when he's gone. It's a stipend. But you know I need the work. I wouldn't do it for free, right? You know me. So, anyways, now that I'm done...
I don't see any plants.
Time out. Give me a moment. I found out that this is the Jack from Jack and the Beanstalk. Unlike all the other tales that Jack has been told about, that he's just a guy going in there and stealing from an evil giant, no. Jack was always a con man, even as a kid. He just was trying to get a get-rich-quick scheme by stealing the goose that laid the golden eggs. So he was actually always a scumbag. Just wanted to let you all know that he's always been a thief. Here we go.
Hey!
Nope.
Okay.
Hell no.
You got
I
me.
Will break you.
Just take it easy.
I don't like being lied to.
Okay.
Not
okay.
Right now, man. I'll fucking hit you hard. Drop the bag.
I heard Crane was leaving town. I figured he owed us little people a parting gift.
He owed you a parting gift.
You heard?
I have my sources, okay? You see how he lives. He doesn't need any of this shit. A little Robin Hooding never hurt anyone, right?
And you heard this from?
What does it matter? I hear things.
I want to know who you heard this from.
What do you want me to say?
Tell me the fucking truth before.
I got bills to pay. Not like Crane's gonna use any of this stuff. All right?
Did somebody send you and tell the truth?
No, it's just me. Just take it easy. You know, this tortured, lonely pig-eater bit's gonna get old eventually. Don't you get tired of it? I mean, what are you even doing here?
I'm looking for Crane.
Wandering around Crane's apartment? What's
I'm
the
looking...
Point?
I'm trying to find Crane's witch. He's supposed to be heading there.
Crane's witch? Is that why he took off? Who the fuck cares about any of that? I mean, don't you think, solving these murders should be your top priority?
He's involved in this.
Let me tell you. People haven't forgotten about those at all. It's all anyone ever talks about. They want to know what's going on.
Crane's definitely involved in all of this. I just need to track him down. Then I'll know more.
Involved? How do you mean?
That's all I'm gonna tell you.
Yep.
Sure.
I don't want to string him up until I know he's guilty of...
Looks like you've got it covered. Anyway, it was really nice catching up with you. I mean that.
Jack? You're not going
Bigby,
anywhere.
I believe you're blocking the doorway there. If I could just squeeze through.
Not happening, friend.
You know, on second thought, it's actually funny I ran into you like this. I think I can help
you.
You're
gonna try to run? What do you mean? Well, I'm listening.
If it's information you want, I'm the guy to ask.
Well, tell me.
I'm listening.
I'm listening.
If you're looking for Crane's witch, well, I just happen to know who she is.
I bet you don't.
Information comes at a price, though. But I'm sure you already knew that.
How convenient.
Convenient for you, Sheriff. I got the info you need. This is an easy win.
I don't believe you. You're fucking lying to me.
I told you about Crane's witch, and you forget you saw me here. One hand washes the other sort of thing.
Nope.
Wipe the whole incident under the rug.
I don't make deals with thieves, Jack. For all I know, you're making all this shit up just to get out of trouble.
Yep.
Give me a little credit here, man. Would I do that to you?
Yes, you would!
How about this? How about I tell you so you know I'm good for it? Then you can reconsider my offer, okay?
Her name is Auntie Greenleaf. Crane's been trying to keep it under wraps for years.
What?
I'm not sure what kind of a deal he's made with her, but from what I hear, he's in pretty regular contact.
Where can I find her?
Well, you see, the thing is, I don't know where you'd find her, exactly.
You gotta be fucking kidding me.
But even a name is a good start, right? I mean, that's more than what you came in with.
And how do I know you're telling the truth, Jack?
I'll keep my eyes open for you. If I find anything else you might be interested in, I'll be sure to let you know. Well, I think you've got plenty to keep you busy. So, I'll, it was
Jack?
Just running into you, baby.
Hang on a second.
Oh, come on.
Let's see what you had, Mr. Jack. Silverware. Oh, glamour tube.
The white deer.
Do you always talk to yourself like that?
Don't press your luck.
The witch uses the white deer on everything. It's her symbol or trademark, I guess. Figured I could sell these at the Lucky Pawn.
The Lucky Pawn?
It's one of the Crooked Man's places. I work there sometimes. When I need some stability.
This Crooked Man...
pawn shop. Get it?
Yeah. You find any more of these?
No.
Liar. Wanna try that
again? Try that again?
Huh.
That it?
Bigby? Are you still here?
Just keep your mouth shut, all right?
You're the boss.
Who are you talking to? What's he doing here?
Evening, Miss White.
Good evening. What's going on?
He's here to help. Jack had some information about Crane's witch.
Oh, what did you find out?
Her name is Greenleaf.
Auntie Greenleaf.
But he doesn't know where we can find her.
Great. Crane's meeting her at 2 a.m.
And Snow, I found a note with some money attached. Crane has been embezzling from Fable Town.
Of course, because why half-ass being a complete sleazeball? Do you think this is tied to the murders? I mean...
might be.
I guess it doesn't matter yet. We still have to find him.
I don't know.
Maybe. I don't know if it's connected.
Crane's
might be, though.
Leaf at 2 a.m. And we have no idea where she is. We're going to cut it close as it is. We have to figure out where he's meeting her.
Wouldn't she be listed in the business office?
I've had Buffkin searching for any unauthorized witches, but so far we haven't found anything. I'll give him the name, but we don't have time to wait around. You should try Holly's. She still has all of Lily's things.
If she hasn't burned it already.
There's still Tweedledee's place. We know they're involved. And we know that's where Bluebeard went. Where do you want to go? We don't have much time.
No. Another decision. Oh, the trip prep. Lily. What if she burned all her things? Dee and Dumb are involved with the Crooked Man, and the Crooked Man's involved with Crane, and Crane is involved with the Tweedles. So it might be there, but Bluebeard might fuck us over. This Bluebeard might know what's going on. Shit. I guarantee that she probably got her things burned. I bet the trip trap is just literally a dead end. We're gonna go to D.N. Dumb's office.
Pay the Tweedle brothers a visit. I'm sure they know something.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's give
this a shot.
And hope he finds something in the records.
Let me know what he comes up with.
I'll be in touch. I hope you'll do the same.
We'll catch him, Snow.
I wanted to make
Hang
sure
on,
Jack.
I want to talk to you.
Yeah, I figured he was gonna try escaping. I had a feeling having Jack free to do what he needs to do or whatever he wants to do is a good idea because he's a necessary evil right now. I need him to stay out of prison so I can get more information out of him.
Hi, Bluebeard. Oh, no,
I'm sorry, big guy. You can't come in. Yeah, because the thing is, and I don't know if you'd heard, but I'm a third-degree black belt and, whatever. So I wouldn't take any chances, hombre. Last guy who messed with me got his marbles kicked right through his abdomen, all right?
Excuse me.
Oh.
Who are you?
Hi, Sheriff.
Flycatcher.
Flycatcher? That's Flycatcher?
What brings you here?
Are you okay? Your face.
Bluebeard was here.
Oh.
He was looking for something. I don't know what. He said it was an official investigation. But how was I supposed to know if he was telling the truth?
It kinda is, but...
Shit.
Found what he was looking for, I guess. It's just super annoying.
What did he take?
What did he take?
Sorry.
I don't know what he wanted. I didn't see what he did after... I'm really sorry, Bigby.
That's okay, Flycatcher. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to make it sound... Was he telling the truth?
He said you sent him, but I don't know. I just thought he was lying. I'm not supposed to just let people in here. But then he got mad, saying, oh, just terrible things.
He was lying. I didn't send him here. You did the right thing.
Okay. Good. Oh, I'm gonna get fired. Crane already let me go from the woodlands.
Is that why you're here?
He said I just got in the way. Told me to get lost. The twins offered me a job here working the night shift, so I'd have something. What do I do now? It's nice, you know, quiet. I come in and clean up. They're usually pretty nice, understanding. There's no way they'll be okay with this, though.
Well, Crane is gone now. I can't see why he couldn't come back to the woodlands.
Really?
Yep.
That would be... Thank you.
Come by
you
the
deserve better.
Office. I can't make any promises.
Right, all the fables do.
Look,
all the
I'm
fables need
out
better.
Of time.
Oh, fuck.
Shit.
Is everything okay?
I gotta go.
What? Where?
I'm headed to the Trip Trap. Just call Snow and tell her what's happened, okay?
Damn it, I made a wrong
do
decision.
That for me?
Okay, I guess.
I'm sorry.
Job, all right?
Sure.
Damn it.
Sure. Take care of yourself, Fly.
You too, Sheriff Bigby.
Poor Flycatcher. But right now, we need to figure out what is going on. We need to find some information, and I screwed up. Ah, damn it. Oh, why? Why do I make horrible decisions?
Damn it.
But I'm probably come too late. I've come too late, and by now they're probably due to.
She's asleep, you fucking idiot. You didn't even give me a chance to explain.
I should have listened to that. My bad.
Talk to Holly.
Oh my god, he's drunk as fuck.
Woody, it's the sheriff.
Hi, Woody. What are you doing here, man?
Buddy.
You're very, very drunk.
What? He's a traveler. A weary traveler in search of some hospitality, right? Right? I mean, you must not be feeling too good after that shit show.
Shit!
Come on. Sit down over here.
Damn it, I missed
the
click
fuck,
button.
Man, I'm in a good goddamn mood. You should all take advantage.
I think maybe we should. I think he might be right to take advantage of him because he, in all honesty, is always a jerk because he doesn't like
I
noise.
I want a drink. Anybody else want a drink?
Friend, Swinehart said you shouldn't mix
you
it.
You think
with...
I give a fuck what that fucking guy says or what you say?
Oh, poor Woody.
Grant, really, you shouldn't drink right now.
I can't hear you when you mumble.
You should quit while you're ahead with that stuff. I might need your help.
Holly's asleep in back, but you won't be able to wake her.
Really? The doc gave him both barmesidal ambrosia for the pain.
Look, the deal is, if you resist going to sleep... Like I am right now. It gives you a very, very, very nice high.
Huh. Okay, I can see why you're staying up then.
He said that he shouldn't mix it with alcohol.
I don't know if that's such a good idea.
Yes, he did.
You shouldn't...
He certainly did. But let me tell you something. I haven't felt this good in a long time, fat boy.
But...
And I feel like having a drink, okay?
Have you seen her sister's things? What wasn't burned at the funeral? I saw her come in with something, but I didn't see where she put it.
Nope, haven't seen it.
Okay. If you say so, but you really shouldn't be doing that.
That funeral back there? That was a shitty fucking send-off for a pretty okay lady.
No.
You weren't fucking there. Talking to Bigby now, okay?
Shh, it's okay, Woody.
Can't
it's okay, don't let him
see. There help things much.
Gren, don't start nothing.
Who's starting anything? I'm not.
I'm
whatever. It's all right. I'm too out of it to get into it.
I don't want to say anything bad to him.
Clear the air. We're all in this dung heap of a fucking shit town together. We're all going to have a toast. All of us.
Fellas, I'm here for one thing. To look through Lily's belongings and get out of here. Now,
yeah,
what?
Yeah, I know. And I want to help you, okay? And I will. But first, indulge me. It'll take 2 seconds. As a show of good faith. And after, we'll all hunt and peck for Lily's shit or whatever.
Grand Bigby didn't come here to get loaded with you.
I don't want
to
get loaded with him.
Fine, we'll have a drink. So long as this goes smoothly. Let's do it. Let's get this over with. So, yes, let's get this done and over with. Have a drink. Everybody... Have a good time for a moment. Glenn?
Gren, the doc said you needed to rest.
How many times you fucking don't warn me about it, huh? You're not my fucking mother, so just get off my back.
I said I was sorry, all right? I can't do anything about it. It's done.
Stop. Separate them. Stop that. We don't need this right now. Please.
What more do you want? What else can I fucking say here?
I don't want anything from you, Woody.
What is the problem here? What stupid shit will you both not let go of?
Oh, I forgot. You haven't heard the news. This walking
what news?
Cake was paying Holly's sister to let him fuck her behind all of our backs. And Holly had to find out going through all of her sister's shit. What fun that must have been. Trick after trick of this fat ass and Lily.
I didn't plan for that, all right? And our thing, whatever it wasn't a big deal. It wasn't. I never fucked her when she was Snow, and I didn't know nothing about that.
No, but you knew Holly would flip out, and you knew for a damn good fucking reason.
This is,
you know,
so
what?
Screwed
fuck
up.
This. I don't need this shit.
Oh, yeah, that's it. Now you're teary-eyed. You were always such a lowlife. I don't know why I never realized it till now. What do you think about this fucking loser, Sheriff?
He can think whatever he wants. I don't give a shit.
No, that's okay, because I'll tell you what he thinks.
I have questions.
I've got some questions for you.
What possible questions could you have for this piece of shit? Everything's a problem when I want to talk. But when the woodsman's about to leave, it's, oh wait, I have questions.
What do you want?
Why did you run?
When Tweedledee came in here 2 nights ago, why'd you run? I was scared, okay? I didn't want to go down for something I didn't do. I never would have hurt that girl, Bigby. All right.
I should have asked him about the witch, but, just, Grin. I don't know. I'm not in my right state of mind.
I don't know where shit is. Check Holly's room. I don't know. But I wouldn't wake her if I were you. Sleepwalkers and trolls. I think that's the rule. Maybe, ogres, too.
Okay, I'm sorry. I should have... I keep missing the time.
What a day. Am I right, Sheriff? What a fucking day.
Well... Gren won't remember this. Maybe that's a good thing. Maybe it's a good thing Gren won't remember any of this. Hello, Holly. Oh boy. I might want to be careful about all of this, because this might turn out really bad for me. Okay. So I must end that episode there, because we've been going on for a long, long, long time. A lot longer than I thought we'd be. So hopefully you guys have been enjoying this episode as much as I have, and I will see you all next time. Bye, guys! Lady, pretty creepy, pretty creepy, pretty creepy. He's a man who had a burn scar on his face and body, cause he was a bad man. Bad man who was bad. Bad putty cat. Bad putty tat. He's a bad putty tat. Bad, so bad. He's so bad. Such a bad titties. Bad titties! Bad, so many bad titties. I have bad titties. My titties killed a man yesterday.